Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming tonight. Please welcome the Laguna Beach High School faculty. Please welcome your 2021 Laguna High School graduates. welcome to our 2021 Laguna Beach High School commencement ceremony. At this time, it's my honor and pleasure to introduce our principal, Dr. Jason Allman.
Students, please be seated. Fair warning, my allergies are acting up tonight, so my eyes might be a little watery. But parents, board members, cabinet members, I'd like to present to you the class of 2021. Great to be here all together on our campus tonight. And I'd like to take some time to explain the tassels and cords that some of our students are wearing. Students with a GPA of a 3.5 or above wear a gold tassel in addition to their LBHS maroon and white tassel. Students with a GPA of a 4.0 or above wear a gold tassel and a gold honor cord. Students awarded the Breakers Medallion Award are wearing their medals this evening. Students, would you please stand so that we may recognize your achievement? Thank you. At this time, I would also like to acknowledge the Laguna Beach High School Academic Athletes of the Year. Congratulations to Maya Shaw with a 4.2 GPA. As well as Matteo Bianchi with a 4.4 GPA. Also being acknowledged this evening are the Laguna Beach High School Athletes of the Year. Cross country, water polo, and swimming athlete Jesse Rose. And an all-around great athlete and even better young man, Nolan Ness. Finally, please help me congratulate the LBHS Athletes of Character. Both of these people make everyone they are around better people. So congratulations to Tess Booth and Arthur Ranagi. I'd also like to take a moment to recognize our staff. At this time, staff, could you please stand? I know I usually speak on behalf of the staff, but tonight I'd like to speak on behalf of our greater school community and accept our gratitude for your work, support, dedication, to our students for the past year and 15 months. I know it's not been easy, and your efforts are appreciated. Thank you, staff. I would like to begin our ceremony by introducing our guests joining us this evening. That includes Board of Education President, Ms. Carol Normandin, Board of Education Clerk, Ms. Kelly Osborne, Board of Education members, Dr. James Kelly, Ms. D. Perry, and Ms. Jan Vickers. Additionally, from our district team, who we greatly appreciate the support over the year, Superintendent Dr. Jason Valoria, Assistant Superintendent of Instruction, Dr. Chad Mayberry, Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources, Mr. Mike Conlin, and of course, our new Public Information Officer, Ms. Shelley Spresser. I also can't forget to welcome and thank my two-time teacher guest speaker, as I've been principal here, Mr. Mark Alvarez. At this time, I have the pleasure to introduce Senior Class President Keller Kramer to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Audience, please stand. Ladies, you may keep your cap on. Gentlemen, please remove your caps. Please join me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Please be seated.
I have the pleasure tonight to introduce Audrey Sutton to give our senior address.
Hi, everyone. In creative writing, I was prompted to write an ode about something I deeply care for. Without hesitation, I unraveled my love for our class of 2021. Now, though that was a raw testament to my beloved class, it was written from 11:50 to 58 the night it was due. I'm sorry, Mrs. Honeycutt. And I owe my people a better farewell than that. So here I am with my final story. Thank you and goodbye. I moved to Laguna from Northern California in fourth grade. And as I was pried off my old best friend's steps while bawling my eyes out, I was convinced it may be the worst thing to ever happen to me. On my first day at Top of the World, my shy self tried impressing new friends with a front flip. When I saw my van slip in front of me and felt my body submerge into the grass, I was so overtaken with embarrassment, I was now convinced that this move really was the worst thing to ever happen to me. To my surprise, I had girls running over to pick me up. And it's only because I can say with confidence that if I fell down right here and now, I would have these same people behind to catch me. I am certain of one thing. Moving to Laguna was the best thing to ever happen to me. It's easy to forget the little blessings we're surrounded by, but each of us has been gifted to experience the community of Laguna Beach. A shout out to the families, by blood and by love, who work effortlessly to cultivate our best lives. Our future aspirations are rooted in your success, and dozens of you sitting in the crowd have played a truly transformational role in my life. A shout out to our otherworldly faculty and teachers. I am awed by the ease you graced us with this past year amidst so much change. I don't know if many schools have a Mrs. Honeycutt who will single-handedly create a new curriculum so students can think outside the box, a Miss Denton who takes summer classes so that she can teach computer science, a senior Garvey who lends a hand and swift piece of advice every day, or a Mrs. Ship who helps seek and distribute hundreds of thousands of dollars to help us start our lives. Above all, a shout out to the ones this speech is really for. You guys, the class of 2021. I look into the crowd and I see my best friends. I see the teammates who push me to race into a finish line with everything I have. I see the girls I grew up with and wonder how we jump from making dirtless diva desk cleaning promo videos to graduation so quickly. I see the classmates who spent an extra 20 minutes per problem in Mrs. Quigley's room so that I could understand. I see the boys who will spit nonstop jokes at each other, but to be fair, and I recite this because I feel it embodies our whole grade, Colton once explained it to me as, they will mess with you harder than anybody else, but if they ever saw someone mess with you, they'd be the first to have your back. And I see those of you who, even when we don't catch up in months, if I'm walking down the hall overstressed, ask what's wrong and offer a shoulder to lean on. When I see you guys, I see kindness, compassion, determination, optimism, and strength. As we mark the first graduation ceremony to happen here on the field, it's no understatement to say we didn't have the classic senior year we always envisioned. But the tribulations we encountered, from the global quarantines and losses to even spiked college admissions, are what proved to me how much this class has to be proud of. Despite these challenges, we came together and gave light in every dark place. We've coordinated, and by we, I mean Izzy, the ASB gods and hardworking mothers, Zooms and breakfasts and field stakeouts to unite us. We've left our first footprints in the world with groups of classmates distributing masks and cookies and care boxes to all the essential workers. And Liam writing an entire book on vaccines. Ella helping document over 50 families in the pandemic. Mateo training into a 4:11 mile. And of course, both the Matthews donating hundreds of service hours to yours truly. In all forms of tutoring me in calc or bio to helping me with any boy endeavors. If this speech could go on forever, there would be a noteworthy thing that each of us has accomplished. Up until about a year ago, most of us had carefully sculpted lives, whittled perfectly to the point of getting us to this very day still intact, coordinated down to the second so that we could fit school, sports, work, volunteering, friends, and family duties all in one day. And then, as we lived on the tightrope of junior year, when it felt like one small tap would ruin us, the entire ground shifted below. We had to reconstruct, rely on each other, and prove our resilience. Even though this was truly testing, it provided us with the greatest lessons of all. As we go on to start paving our own paths, we have these secret weapons that many classes before us didn't have. The ability to show up every day and give our all through the best and worst of times, and the adaptability to face any circumstance. We also have the wisdom to know that we are allowed to have bumps in the road and to embrace ourselves as a perpetual work in progress. Finally, we learn that our path doesn't have to have a set destination, because as we've now experienced and always hear, life is so much more about the journey than the destination. It took a long time to hit me that this portion of our journey is over because it sped by so quickly. In the midst of high school, you get home every day and feel like the extent you've learned has been a battle in the American Revolution or a new physics equation. But within the blur is much more. We each have our individual takeaways, but to leave you all with two, I've learned to cherish the people I love and the time I have with them, because we never know when it will be ripped away. And also, if you're camping, to never let Chase near the speaker again. We've definitely all learned way too many lessons, but I suppose that's what these years are meant to be about. 1,384 days ago, we first walked onto this beautiful campus that we now call home. We heard Joey Ravenna promise over the loudspeaker, "It's a great day to be a breaker," and crouched as upperclassmen, future workloads, and 4 years of adventure towered over us. Today, we've made it to our last walk onto campus as a LBHS student. In that short period of time, we have grown tall, solely metaphorically in my case, but still, grown tall to match these scary things that once towered us. In the process, we have written so many stories together. Even though everyone's story is different, we will forever hold a special bond that we started ours together at Laguna Beach High School. When we branch off next year across the globe, I hope you are able to take our story and spread it. Spread the unique legacy of love that our class of 2021 has brought us. I hope it connects you to others and inspires you to bond with those of different stories, beliefs, personalities, and backgrounds. Let our legacy be an impact that lasts. Right now, the world could use a little more of us. So, with that said, thank you with all of my heart to the class of 2021 for letting me be a part of your story and making every day as a breaker the best day. Thank you. I did it!
Thank you, Audrey, for your kind words. And now, I would like to introduce Matthew Duong, your class of 2021 valedictorian.
I'd like to thank all the teaching and non-teaching staff, all the administration and aides, and all the family and friends that made this all possible. It really does mean a lot to us to be able to have an event like this, so we thank you. So I'll be honest here. I didn't know I actually had to write this speech until Mrs. Jones asked if I had written it yet. So sorry, Mrs. Jones. What I've prepared today is not a Shakespearean monologue. Instead, it's a simple message I wanted to share with you all. I come from a very study-centric family. It's been all about academics since day one. For example, when my sister told my dad she was going to active culture with her friends, he thought she was going to do a bacterial lab for AB Bio. Love you, Dad. With this kind of family environment, I was bound to be one for staying in my own lane to complete the goal. And so I went into my underclassmen years with this distance notion that school was only a place to learn the subjects of the day. Day in, day out, it was my nose in the Euro book, shout out to True Patterson, or another revision of the chem lab that always seemed to score lower as the year went on. I was obsessed with studying little things like the defenestration of Prague, or like the names of obscure characters like Solomon from Tale of Two Cities. The point is, I wasn't focusing on what I loved. And what do I love? Tennis, namely the connections and team building that came out of it. You know, tennis was initially a PE credit and get out after 2 years thing, but I ended up spending 4 years with the team. I've never been a Nolan Ness or a Matteo Bianchi, but what I love about this sport is the building of a family through competition, and winning's pretty good too. When junior year rolled around though, COVID doomed us to a life of a simple click of the leave meeting button. With it, all of our friends, peers, teachers would just be gone. Suddenly our season was canceled. The tennis team was doomed to practice individually, which meant no practice when we can get away with it. And we never got to really say goodbye to our seniors. Without live ball and the hardship of competition, I thought I felt myself drifting farther from the tennis family, let alone the rest of LBHS. But without the bustle of live everyday school life, I learned that family can be found in the little things. With every one of Senora Garcia's breakers, breakers, da da da, I'd first give an awkward laugh, but then I'd admire the passion that our teachers put into each lesson. All the trivial chats and the passings of a proverbial ball were little trinkets used to build a school family around something that at first felt so bland, a Zoom class. Every mention of Shelby in South Korea was a little weird, but it brought us together as a class family by gathering us around these strange jokes. And so when I came to Mr. Brovik's classroom for his help in resuscitating the really rough draft of the speech, it didn't feel like I was meeting like Sal Khan or the guy from Bozeman Science. It was like meeting a mentor I've had for years. Our teachers made an artificial world an intimate one, and we're very lucky to have them. So can we give them a round of applause? And of course, my own family during this strange year. It'd always be an absolute mad dash when the Wi-Fi went out during work hours. It'd always be a nagging to get out of our rooms and stay healthy. But there'd also always be food on the table and the love of chauffeuring me to tennis games even when their schedules were booked. Sometimes there'd even be an offer to take over chores, now that's a rare one, and a reassuring smile. Hours upon hours of quarantine together for anyone was bound to lead to some friction, but not once did they stop supporting my sister and me. Mom and Dad, thank you for loving us, guiding us, and let's face it, putting up with us. I don't know where you are, but thank you. My peers this year have made an incredible effort to not only create a sense of normalcy, but to go above and beyond with ensuring one another's enjoyment. My freshman self would have never thought I'd end up sitting in a beach chair in the desert. Each attempt to get me to stay in contact, to branch out, made me appreciate what people are doing for me in the present, to live in the moment. I learned to ease my eyes off the goal every now and then, to notice what's around me. And what I see is a big family. My personal family, the tennis family, the family forged through distance learning, and the Breaker family as a whole. We've seen the worst of technical difficulties in Quigley's quirky calc jokes, and we're closer because of it. I've learned this year that it's through real adversity and the resilience that follows that families grow closest. And from this family, I've realized that success isn't all about honing in on a single goal. Probably giving my parents a heart attack right now. I'll try to get A's next year, I promise. It was the passion in the teaching and the undying love in our family that taught me that it's mostly about being satisfied with how you get to wherever you're meant to be, and I'm very thankful for that. I'm so glad to have known you all, and I wish you all happiness in whatever you choose to do. Congratulations, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you again, Matthew. I would like to welcome Dr. Allman back to the podium to address the graduates.
Good evening. Considering the circumstances, before I share my words with our class of 2021, I would like to invite any former Laguna Beach High School alumni out in the crowd tonight, especially any members of the class of 2020, to please stand. Thank you, alumni, and especially members of the class of 2020 for making our extended school community an amazing one. Class of 2020, wow, what a year, huh? Over the past 15 months, you, this amazing group of young adults, were faced with obstacles, letdowns, an entirely different landscape of our world. And today, we come together as a community on our own campus to celebrate and honor the hard work of you, the class of 2021. This seems like the perfect and most appropriate setting for us all to be together after what we've been through as a school and a community, doesn't it? On behalf of our staff at the high school, I want to thank the parents and our greater school community for your support throughout the year. It feels right that we are all here on campus together. One last time for our class, the class of 2021. So you may not know this, but you, the class of 2021, hold a special place in my heart here at LBHS. My first year here as the LBHS principal was your first year here as a freshman. We have gone through our 4 years at Breaker Nation together. In our 4 years, we've managed adjusting to a new school, cramming in passing grades, hard work, wins and losses on our fields and courts, a global pandemic, approximately 140 camo Fridays, a number of bell schedules, and the excitement of coming back to campus. Yes, we were actually excited about being back on school campus. So through all of that, you've provided me and many other adults on campus that are lucky enough to educate and work with you some amazement and hope. Your flexibility, your resilience, your willingness to find the positive in so many of the challenges you have faced in your time here, especially in those last 15 months, gives me pause, it gives me confidence, and it gives me hope for our world moving forward. And for that, I thank you. So, seniors, as you're surrounded by your teachers, family, friends who've supported you along the way, please take a moment to acknowledge what you have been through, the accomplishments you were a part of, the challenges you've navigated, and most importantly, the attitude and effort you bring to your experiences. Good or bad, easy or difficult, together or alone. After all the challenging and rigorous courses you have taken, I would like to leave you with a fairly simple approach towards success in life. Be reminded that whatever it is you face moving forward, you will always have two things totally in your control: your attitude and your effort. Take that concept to heart. Choose to always be positive and assume good intentions in your attitude. Choose to always put forward your best effort in all you do. That will lead inevitably to your success. So please join me with your family, the faculty and staff of Laguna Beach High School, to offer our congratulations to you, the class of 2021. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Allman. And now for our final speaker of the evening, I'd like to invite Mr. Mark Alvarez to the stage and ask for his address to our 2021 graduates.
Wow, thank you. I'm flattered you all think I have something to add to this thing. And I agree, great venue, better than the Irvine Bowl for sure. Great venue. I'm going to start with, somebody gave me this advice on my wedding night, and I think it holds true for y'all right now. Right now, bear with me. It's another weird Alvarez thing, but close your eyes. Close your eyes. Come on. I'm only half you have your eyes closed. Take a deep breath in with the nose, out with the mouth. One more time. Deep breath in with the nose, out with the mouth. Look around. You're not going to see half those people pretty soon here. Enjoy this. This moment's gonna go away really quick. Enjoy it. Booker, Zoe, other ASB students. I guess I did see that message on my board, huh? It's kind of weird. Chase, you too. So I went home the evening I saw that message on the board, and I mentioned to my wife that I was gonna give the commencement address. I asked her for some ideas. I told her I didn't have anything left in the tank. I'm drained after this past year. She said, honey, don't worry about it. No one remembers your last speech, and certainly no one's going to remember this one. Just find your old one and recycle it. So at first I was insulted, but then I realized, wow, she is beautiful and a genius. So I ran to my old yearbook where I stashed a copy of the old speech. I read it, and nope, wasn't going to work. Not for this year's class. So then I thought, what about a speech that centers around resilience? Bouncing back after a challenging year, I'll make Arthur Ranaghi the star of the speech. Talk about resilience, one blow after the next this last trimester, wrapping it up with a concussion that some kid made with a cheap shot on the basketball court. Arthur rises from the ashes, finishes the trimester strong, and is heading to the Air Force Academy to give service to our wonderful country. Now that's a speech. In the end, though, I did what a lot of you would have done. I headed to the ATM, I took out a couple $100s, and I begged Luke Teeple to write this speech. And here's what he came up with. I'm kidding. I'll tell you what, the speech would have been a whole lot better if he did write it. What an amazing kid. And boss. He ran the mentorship program here at the high school, like an absolute pro. So finally, when I sat down this afternoon to write this speech, I decided to borrow some lessons from a couple of the greats. I drew inspiration from Einstein, an international business professor I once had, and Anthony Bourdain. So it's a bit of a Franken speech, or is what you kiddies might call it, a mashup. So here it goes. Reflecting on this last year, I realized one thing I am grateful for, and that's where we live. There are a lot of places that would have made quarantine more challenging, either weather-wise or with fewer outdoor activities to enjoy. Laguna is an amazing town, though a distant second to San Clemente. But I also realize the one thing I've missed this year, it's travel. I thought about why travel is something I love so much and I love doing with my family. And I realized it isn't just about seeing the different places. It's about the perspective that travel gives us about the world and the way it teaches us to see things through different lenses. The idea of seeing things from different perspectives was studied by Einstein. He looked at it from the standpoint of physics, and what he concluded is that if we look through things through different lenses, then what we actually see will be different. In his example, he used a moving train through the perspective of two different people, one who is sitting on the train looking forward, and another outside the train looking at it from the side. He explained that if lightning strikes the front and the back at the exact same time, the person outside the train will say the bolts hit the train simultaneously, because the light will hit their eyes at the exact same time. However, the person sitting on the train facing forward sees the bolt that hit the front first and believes the bolt hit the back later, because the light doesn't hit their eyes until later. The takeaway is that both perspectives are true, but it depends on which lens you're looking through. Now, I'm no physicist, though I did go down a huge rabbit hole writing this speech. Special relativity, can't even say it, length contraction, time dilation, and other rules of physics while writing this. Remember, I'm an econ guy. I'm about as accurate as the weatherman. So I may not have gotten the explanation exactly right, but hopefully you get the point. The application to life is that we have to view things through different lenses, see things from another perspective sometimes. This is what builds empathy, compassion, and understanding. It's an essential ingredient for being a great leader, and I think a good person. So bringing it back to travel, some of my favorite advice from Anthony Bourdain has to do with perspective. If you're not familiar with Anthony Bourdain, he was a chef, a travel journalist, an author that I admired, and who left his mark on the world. He said, and I quote, "As you move through life in this world, you change things slightly. You leave marks behind, however small. And in return, life and travel leaves marks on you. Most of the time, those marks are beautiful. Often, though, they hurt. Travel isn't always pretty, it isn't always comfortable, and it even breaks your heart sometimes. But that's okay. The journey changes you. It should change you. It leaves marks on your memory, on your consciousness, on your heart. You take something with you. Hopefully, you leave something good behind. Remember that, my friends and class of 2021, as you travel through the next chapter in your life. It may be hard sometimes, but again, that's okay. It's all part of it. Take something with you and leave something good behind. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2021. You did it."
Thank you, Mr. Alvarez. And now that what we've been waiting for, I'll invite Dr. Alleman back to the podium.
Would the first row of graduates please come forward? Board President Normandin, would you please join me at the podium? Thank you. As the principal of Laguna Beach High School, and on behalf of its faculty, I certify the class of 2021 has met the requirements for graduation. It is with great pleasure that I present the class of 2021 to the Board of Education. I am proud to recommend the senior class for graduation.
On behalf of the Board of Education, I accept the graduating class of 2021 and declare our seniors eligible to receive their diplomas.
Colin J. Abbott.
Abaroza.
Faith Audrey Ackley.
Layla Al Alawi.
Leela Fong Andringa.
Mia Elizabeth Armstrong.
Tyler Joe Alishava Aaron.
Nikki Tiffany Asgari.
Alessi Bebla Avaz.
Ella Janae Baumgarten.
Kylie Beatty.
Clara Amaris Becker.
Matthew Henry Burke.
Hannah Tarek Berry.
Matteo Bianchi.
Sophie Chalmers Black.
Emma Ladergrown.
Fatima Blanco.
Casey James Bone.
Tess Marion Booth.
Willis Blair Boyd the Fourth.
Tess Heather Brobeck.
Brooklyn Jade Bryan.
Jesse Luca Buckle.
Haley Einvon Bui.
Harper Reese Bunn.
Finnegan Cole Butler.
Diego Lapayeze Calderon.
Catherine Grace Callahan.
Reese Dylan Campbell.
Maddie Leone Carlson.
Zoe Anna Carlton.
Isaac Jacob Carter.
Haley Berry Carter.
Luke Brian Carter.
Rachel Grace Carver.
Jeremy Castillo.
Giovanna Elizabeth Chakuti.
Imani Rose Clemens.
William Philip Compton.
Kennedy Sophia Corlett.
Ryan Elizabeth Cordalesa.
John Thomas Cololius.
Joshua Thomas Cutcomb.
Ariana Donishman.
Ella Lois D'Artes.
James Ryan Davison.
Alaya Nio Dawson.
Jamie Decker.
Jonathan Delgado.
Sasha DeMille Odison.
Cecilia Anna Jerv.
James Bryant Dobbs Hildreth.
Alex Dominguez.
Henning Hans Doring.
Zachary Mark Duncan.
Matthew Tuan Duong.
Taylor Lynn Durant.
Mark Theodore Eftimi.
Samuel David Ike II.
Sydney Taylor Eckberg Rogers.
Darian Hadi Fakori. Joseph Fecker.
Lydia Nicole Flathman.
Jack Douglas Frederick.
Booker Charles Frith.
Chloe Ann Gabora.
Maya Borkowski Gallego.
Gavin Daniel G.
Grace Elizabeth Gillis.
Trenton Phelps Gillis.
James Wyatt Gillespie.
Amber Wei-Sing Go.
Jackson Thomas Golden.
Lauren May Good.
Hannah Lee Taylor Green.
Haley Elise Gurney.
Emily Rachel Guthrie.
Lucas James Hagopian.
Chase Lance Hall.
Taylor Sue Halverson.
Sydney Michelle Hardy.
Brooke Noelle Hardy.
Mason Taylor Hart.
Hakam Salahuddin Hassan.
Lucky Star Hauer.
Zachary Christopher Henderson.
Evan James Henry.
Brennan Lee Hoyland.
Serena Mahmoud Mohammed Hoso.
Joseph Dikranter Hovanesian.
Lucas Anthony Jablon.
Carter Scott Johnson.
Alexander John Josephs.
Gianna Karina Josephs.
Nicholas George Josephs.
Quinn Andrew Josephs.
Ryan Ken Kawashiri.
Catherine Rose Kellenberg.
Benjamin Hiram Keller.
Ben John Robert Kelly.
Skylar Olivia Kidd.
Caroline Cheryl Kimball.
Samantha Rose Kimball.
Caitlin Ashley Kohlberg.
Zachary Coster.
Ethan Charles Kramer.
Keller Griffin Kramer.
Griffin Scove Christensen.
Jacob Gregory Cooper.
Johanna Opal Legault.
Emma Jane Lineback.
Tyson Lewis Lockhart.
Luisa Giovannina Lofranco.
Michaela Ann Lopez.
Evan Christian Louch.
Jordan Raquel Lowe.
Jaden Ryan Lund.
Isabella Monel Lyons.
Ryan Edward McGee.
Keith William McGuire.
Lucas Henry Martin Schimmelfennig.
Charlie Gordon McBean.
Ellie Darian McCarty.
Samuel Darian McCarty.
Aiden Sean McDennon.
Melina Alexis McKibben.
Sage Nicole Miller.
Alexis Brian Monaco.
Alexander Mork.
Faith Christina Morgan.
Keanu Morris.
Brady Alexander Moss.
Mostaho.
Jared Ming Moy.
Is Isabella Christina Mullen.
Andrew Todd Mundy.
Macy Addison Murphy.
Nolan William Ness.
Alexander Lewis Neufeld.
Austin Kyle Newberry.
Janine Malin Nguyen.
Alessandra Natolia.
Ashley Christine Nobles.
Shanti Marie Nunn.
Bianca Isabella Oliveri.
Natalie Christine Olson.
Samantha Ordonez.
Rafael Ortiz Marquez.
Grace Rose Parker.
Kayla Jewel Parker.
Logan Van Parker.
True Robert Patterson.
Macy Lena Peel.
Michael Van Pinto.
Cole Austin Presley.
Liam Rafferty.
Jesus Gerardo Ramirez Castellanos.
Sophia Ravenna.
James Patrick Reed.
Nicholas Paul Reardon.
Nikolai Derek Reed.
Desiree Gabriella Reeder.
Molly Catherine Renner.
Adrian Louise Ritchie Fisher.
Gavin Michael Richards.
Miles Reagan Real.
Benjamin Doran Reamer.
Joshua Michael Rogers.
Jessica Suzanne Rose.
Luke Samuel Roshko.
Arthur Jackson Runagi.
William Glenn Runagi.
Amelie Joanne Sadler.
Taro James Yuzaburo Sakai.
Kimberly Sarahi Sanchez Cornejo.
Rai Angela Sandifer.
Isabella Grace Saunders.
Parker Savage.
Sydney Jane Schaefkin.
Carly Sierra Schwarm.
Rhiannon Lucia Cara Seely.
Maya Sophia Shaw.
Teva Faith Schoenfeld.
Amelia Grace Simmons.
Pearl Ann Sinclair.
Emma Catherine Singer.
Jordan Elisa Citia.
Matthew Logan Skeist.
Michaela Camille Smith.
Natasha Grace Sorensen.
Sarah Delaney Soyular.
Kid Jeffrey Stabline.
Henry Morgan Stewart.
Jacqueline Nicole Strawn.
Nicole Lee Struss.
Sebastian George Stubbs.
Ethan Daniel Surface.
Audrey Kathleen Sutton.
Quinn Joseph Tankersley.
Soren Christopher Teeple. Tigner.
Tatiana Marie Tobin.
Jordan Lynn Troutwine.
Gavin Andrew Trevino.
Christopher Mitchell Trinidad.
Ida Mirabel Tunke.
Ella Rachel Tyus.
Christian Lee Vaccaro.
Maya Luisa Vitas.
Arturo Everardo Vidari Tucker.
Benjamin Gregory Walker.
Colton Thomas Weeks.
Julian James Williams Goldberg.
Grace Alexandra Wilson.
Keegan Patrick Winton.
Shelby Wolf.
Sage Tamonte Woodard.
Sierra Chancellor Woodard. Dylan Noah Zoller.
parents, family, and friends, can we please clap it up one more time for the class of 2021? Friends and family, before I declare the graduates, I would like to ask for you to remain seated while our graduates exit the stadium, and they will come to you in the seating area to find you once the ceremony is concluded. So graduates, this is the moment we've all been waiting for, and it's your final test. If you can't pass it, I'm sorry, you're stuck with me for another year. While you're seated, make sure your tassels are on the right side. So that's this side. And now, the beloved class of 2021, please rise. At this time, please move your tassels from right to left. On behalf of Laguna Beach Unified School District, it's an honor to declare you graduates of Laguna Beach High School. Go Breaker Nation! Yes, you're allowed to throw them. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to the class of 2021.